So what happens when you're hosting a garage sale and you really don't have a garage to go to?
Yeah.
No garage.
You do it on the sidewalk, and that's what's happening this weekend at Wild Birds Unlimited. First, how to get ready for winter visitors.
Marge Knutson is here to educate us on that. She owns Wild Bird Unlimited. Thanks for stopping
Hello,
by.
Hello, Marge.
Hi. Good to see you. Lots of bird species.
Mm-hmm.
They hang around throughout the winter, right?
They do.
In Nebraska.
Uh-huh.
What kind of birds are we talking about?
Oh. Cardinals, blue jays, mm-hmm. chickadees, most of the woodpeckers.
And what should we be feeding them?
Seed and suet with high fat and protein content is
okay.
always good for
they need
winter.
To get that, store that up for the winter
That's
time, right?
That's right.
Mm-hmm. And is bark butter one of those things, high in protein?
Bark butter is one of
is
those
that what we're
things.
Looking at? Is that the bark butter on the side of the tree?
That's right. Beautiful bark butter was originally designed to be fed on the side of the tree.
Mm-hmm. How do they do that? They just slap that on the tree?
Or smear it on with a fork or a knife or
and
something.
It stays,
and it
huh?
stays.
Call it good.
Mm-hmm. So here it is. This is how it comes in the container.
Mm-hmm. Right.
But it's evolved, right? So you've got the original, but mm-hmm. then what's new?
Well, for one thing, the feeders for bark butter, people mm-hmm. got tired of the squirrels
so
eating it
one.
All.
Oh,
this
yeah.
So feeders have been designed to feed bark butter, and then you can put them on
you just spoon it right into these holes, right?
That's right, and put it on a shepherd's crook or under a baffle so the squirrels can't get to it.
Mm-hmm. And we have a few other options
That's
here, too.
That's right. And then the next thing that evolved was bark butter brick, which mm-hmm. is a suet size.
So you don't smear this on anything?
Nope. You just
drop
use
it
a suet
the
feeder. The little
it's the feeder.
The tail prop.
What is the point of the tongue at the bottom of this feeder?
That is a tail prop. It allows the bigger woodpeckers to balance against the prop
oh,
like they would
yeah.
the tree with their tail,
mm-hmm.
so it gives them more stability.
That makes sense. Mm-hmm. And then what else? Moving on down the line
right.
here.
Right.
It's still bark butter?
That's still bark butter, but it's bark butter logs so that it fits in the,
you put it in the
that kind
the
of suet feeder. Right.
Slides right in.
Yeah, and then you smash it together to keep it in and birds eat it.
We've got one more option here.
Right.
How and does this work?
Bark butter bits are little pieces of bark butter rolled in cornmeal
mm-hmm.
so they stay separate and don't
yeah.
get stuck together.
Can you see
you can
it?
Feed them in a little
put them
peanut
in a feeder. Like
feeder
this, right?
Yeah.
Or in a feeder that is a tray feeder.
Mm-hmm. I like that you give us these options, mm-hmm. something that's aesthetically beautiful, and then something here that will withstand Nebraska weather.
That's right.
Yeah, these are made of recycled materials, so they weather
so you
quite
just,
well.
So you just rest this, the bark butter bits into this,
you,
drop them right in there?
You
Pour
just
in.
Drop them right in, or you can mm-hmm. mix them with seed. And
the squirrels
them in
eat
regular
bark butter?
Oh, yes.
They like, oh, okay. So we got another issue
Thus
there.
Thus the yeah. evolution, right,
right,
of the product. And in fact, these products are on sale this month?
They are. We've got an introductory price for all the bark butter mm-hmm. products at 20% off.
Great. So if you're new to it, good time to shop. If you already have it and love it and want to stock up, a good time to shop.
That's right.
You also see their savings on seed cylinders and bird food, and we'll get to some great options within those categories here.
And we were talking nuts at the beginning of the show over at Herman's Nut House, Paris Gourmet. This mm-hmm. isn't exactly what they serve over there. This is a little bit different, right?
A little bit different, but the same principle.
Why are our cylinders a tidy option for homeowners who are tired of having seed all over the grass?
Right. Cylinders are seed or nuts stuck together with gelatin,
mm-hmm.
so the birds can't knock it out of the feeder. They pick it off
mm-hmm.
and eat.
And we have the traditional cylinders here, and
mm-hmm.
I know you have the feeders that you can basically mm-hmm. slide this right on and hang
right.
it, and you're good.
And they have decorative ones, too.
Oh, yeah. So we've seen these in seasons past,
That's right.
right.
The raccoon and owl were
Aren't
here
cute?
Last year.
Yeah.
And they got holes down the middle so you can put mm-hmm. them in these feeders.
Right.
Slide them right
slide
on.
Slide them right on.
But these are new this season. What do you have here?
Well, we have Pip and Squeak, mm-hmm. the black cat, and the little mouse there.
Aren't these adorable?
And the cat slides on the cylinder feeder just like any
yeah.
other cylinder would.
See?
Mm-hmm. And then you just tie the mouse.
How long do these last outside of your house?
How long
does it take before the birds whittle them down to nothing?
A lot of it will depend on how many birds you have.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But they can last quite a while,
yeah.
a week or two.
Yeah.
And we have a giant-sized cylinder that could probably last a month.
You know, some mm-hmm. people are into critters, right? Uh-huh. Whether it's jewelry or clothing, they just love it. I think uh-huh. these are great gifts for people.
They are. They're really fun.
So we've got cylinders, seed, bark butter, all on sale this month, but
right.
that's not the end of it. This Saturday and Sunday, you're hosting that garage sale Mike talked about. So give us an idea of what you'll have out and the types of savings we should expect.
Okay. We are going to have our garage sale on the sidewalk. Many things that are as much as $6 or $7 are going to be less than a dollar.
Wow.
We have some unusual things. We have a large pen that we used when we first got our kittens that is kind of a, like a big rabbit pen. It's big enough to hold a litter pan, a bed, and food, but we're going to sell it now that the kittens are cats.
Right. They're just outgrown it.
Uh-huh. And different things that through the years we've had and we might have odds and ends left or displays that we're no longer using that people have asked about buying in the past.
Yeah, but you're talking deep discounts on some of this stuff. So it's a great sidewalk sale.
Right. Well, and it's like we would do as homeowners if we're having a garage sale. You go to the basement and you say,
get rid of that stuff.
Clear the space. Haven't used it in a while. Right. You're doing the exact same thing in the store.
Exactly.
Yeah, the website, WBUOmaha.com. It's a great resource, and from there you can go sign up and get on the mailing list, the email list, and get great updates on all things birds throughout the course of the year.
It's as much about information as it is product for you, so that we all understand what we're doing and why, and we're really getting the most out of Mother Nature. So right now we're shopping for bark butter products, 20% off this month, and then also 10% off cylinders and bird food this month as well, and then the garage sale this weekend, Marge.
Blue Jays and Cardinals, and among some other birds are going to stick around this
winter. Cardinals, right. My favorite.
And they're so beautiful against the snow in the wintertime.
Bright, right?
Yeah, they remind me of my grandma. If you want to get in touch with Marge, you saw the phone number there.
Was she red?
But she loved Cardinals.
Oh, okay.
And we loved watching them together.
Yes.
So Marge does a blog. Want to tell you about that quickly. You can read up at WBUOmaha.com.
Thanks, Marge.
Thank you
for coming
in.
All right.